It's that time again. Time to make up some theoretical support cards for archetypes that need more support, but will probably never receive any more actual support. The first archetype that's receiving support is a quality one that never seemed to achieve its potential: Mecha Phantom Beasts. The problem with MPBs is that while they have a variety of quality monster choices that combo very well together and can produce some nice effective responses, their spell and trap support is incredibly substandard, forcing somewhat annoying and inconsistent restrictions to effectively utilize them, the spells, or having needless and excessive costs to achieve their effects, the traps. Therefore, in my opinion, the key to significantly improving MPBs is to give them cards that actually allow them to both better control the swarming ability of the opponent and increase the probability of activating their own monster combinations. So, to help MPBs better control the opponent's field, let's look at Bombing Run. Continuous spell. Tribute one Mecha Phantom Beast monster on your field. Until the opponent's next end phase, once per turn during either player's turn, if your opponent special summons a monster or monsters, reduce the attack of one of those monsters equal to the level of the tributed monster when it was tributed, times 200, and negate its effect. If a monster has its attack reduced to zero by this card's effect, destroy that monster and special summon one Mecha Phantom Beast token. During your next standby phase, if a monster tributed for this card's effect last turn exists in your graveyard, you can add it to your hand. Bombing Run actually plays well for both indirect support and theatrical theme, imagining planes flying over the enemy's field, capturing and demonstrating air superiority. This effect makes effective use of the level augmenting characteristic of MPB monsters. Clearly, when a monster is being bombarded from the sky, it will not be focused enough to activate its effect. It'll be quote unquote running for its life, and depending on the number of bombs, it may just out and out be destroyed. With realistic attack drops ranging from 400 to 2000, a higher ceiling is possible over 2000, but not very likely. This card can typically provide a meaningful setback to opponent playmaking, but does not come off as too powerful due to its once per turn effect and the fact that it is a continuous spell card. The second card helps MPBs expand their combination plays among their monsters with more consistency. Special Military Tech. It's a continuous spell. You can only have one copy of Special Military Tech on your field. Once per turn, during either player's turn, you can select one Mecha Phantom Beast monster from your deck or hand and send it to the graveyard. This card's effect becomes the effect of the selected monster until the next end phase. During either player's turn, you can send this card to the graveyard to return up to two Mecha Phantom Beast monsters in the graveyard to your deck and select one of the following effects. Draw one card for each monster returned to the deck by this effect. Special summon one Mecha Phantom Beast token for each monster returned to the deck by this effect. The idea behind Special Military Tech is to significantly increase the combo playmaking and versatility of the deck with its effect copy and deck thinning effects. Basically, military tech is used to create a secondary means of achieving both the token tribute effect, common to most MPBs, and the token summon effect, common to most MPBs. Its send to the graveyard effect also provides strong combo and playmaking potential by producing multiple tokens or drawing cards. The second archetype receiving theoretical support in this discussion is a deck that has an interesting overall theme, focusing on weakening the opponent's monster and then taking advantage of that weakness. Unfortunately, Reptilians only have a very basic support structure, making their play potential and success rather difficult and of low quality right now, especially relative to the existing meta. So, what would I do to change that with only a couple of cards? First, Reptilians need a strong combo-centric monster to act as a linchpin to their combination between the smaller monsters and the bigger monsters. To accomplish this, Reptilian Adder. Dark, Reptile, level 4, 1800 attack, 0 defense. You can send this card from your hand to the graveyard to add one attacking void zone from your deck to your hand. If this card is sent to the graveyard, select one monster on the opponent's field and reduce its attack to zero. Once per turn during either player's turn, when the attack of an opponent's monster is decreased due to a card effect, you can banish this monster from your field until the next end phase to special summon one reptilian monster in your deck. You can only activate this effect of Reptilian Adder once per turn. Adder has three quality effects that would significantly advance the competitiveness of the Reptilian archetype in my opinion. The first effect is the old school terraforming effect to search the archetype specific field spell. That now, if you don't recognize that field spell, that's going to be the second card that will be discussed a little later. I never understood why Konami stopped making cards with this effect, because it definitely produces a quality level of versatility to have a card that can serve as a monster or as terraforming. The second effect helps expand the ability of the archetype to at least reduce the attack points of at least one monster on the opponent's field to zero with relative ease, allowing the player to make better use of monsters like Vasky, Godzilla, or Viper. The nice thing about this part of the effect is that it activates when Adder goes to the graveyard, period, no matter how it happens, opening the door to more effective and creative deck design. The third effect is really the bread and butter effect, for the Reptilian archetype needs more monsters to take advantage of simple attack reduction and actually do something with it. If the attack of any monster in your opponent is reduced by any amount by a card effect, you can banish this card temporarily to summon any Reptilian monster from the deck to the field, producing much better versatility and advantage in addition to combo potential. I did feel it necessary though to add the hard once per turn effect, because otherwise it would be just too easy to snowball this effect, using the first adder to summon a second adder, using the second adder to summon a third adder, using a third adder to summon a fourth Reptilian monster. The aforementioned second card is, of course, Attacking Void Zone. Field spell. Once per turn, add a number of null counters to this card equal to the number of non-token monsters on your opponent's field with zero attack. Once per turn, remove any number of null counters from this card to select one of the following effects. Draw cards equal to the number of removed counters. Add Reptilian cards, except for this card, in your graveyard to your hand equal to the number of removed counters. Negate the effects of a number of opponent monsters equal to the number of removed counters. While I view Adder as the key combo monster for the deck, Attacking Void Zone is obviously the key combo spell card for the deck. Void Zone provides nice versatility among its three different effects. If you've pulled off some nice combinations against your opponent's monsters, and they're sitting there with two or three zero attack point monsters, you can draw lots of cards. You can recover Reptilian cards from the graveyard to produce specific combos, or you can negate monster effects to make it easier to pull off your combinations. The once per turn effect is soft, so you can combo this card with multiple copies of itself for more effect, but you cannot create easy infinite loot. Overall, not surprisingly, I feel these cards would significantly increase the competitive capacity of both Mecha Phantom Beast and Reptilian in the current meta. However, while this support I think would do wonders for the competitive capacity of Mecha Phantom Beast, I feel that Reptilians, even with this support, would still need another quality monster before they could really do some meaningful damage in the meta, but at least with this new support, they wouldn't be kind of viewed as a quasi-joke deck anymore. Well, those are my ideas for new MPB and Reptilian support. Thank you for your attention and your time. I'm out.